Chapter 1163, Crazy, Mismo. How much property would a world king level powerhouse and a world king level holy land have? Lin Ming asked Mo Eversnow. A bit unsure of himself, Mo Eversnow said, property is divided into fixed assets and liquid assets. Whether it is a world king powerhouse or a world king holy land, over 99.9% of their total wealth will be locked down in array formations, palaces, transmission arrays, training locations, pills, treasures, and so forth. They wouldn't have many liquid assets available for them. Having too much money is useless. It's best to invest everything into training disciples and exchanging for resources. In the past, my Verdant Feather Holy Lands only kept around 4-5 trillion in liquid capital, and the Verdant Feather Holy Lands was also a great World King level Holy Land. It was much wealthier than these ordinary World King Holy Lands like Sacred Martial Mansion or Dual Polarity Palace. I estimate that they have a total of 1-2 trillion in liquid assets. Lin Ming nodded. This was a reasonable amount. When the Verdant Feather Holy Lands had been destroyed, Mo Eversnow had quickly snuck away some of the wealth, but that was only a small amount of the total, around a trillion in all. And then later, most of that had been taken away by Mo Eversnow's little sister, leaving less than 400 billion at Starbind Bank. As for an ordinary World King Holy Land, even though their liquid capital was normally around 1-2 trillion, they could sell a small amount of their fixed assets in exchange for Violet Sun Stones. The true value of their property was definitely above his own. Fortunately, a World King Holy Land was far too large. There was more than one peak disciple and there was much more to do than attending a single auction. This meant that the wealth of that Holy Land would be scattered about all over. This was his only chance. As Lin Ming was thinking about his own wealth, the bidding price had already dramatically risen to 3.8 trillion. The one who cast this bid was actually Sacred Yuping. 3.8 trillion was equal to the total liquid capital a normal Upper World King Holy Land would have during normal times. But, this amount was actually tossed out in a single breath in order to buy just one boundless world pill that helped solidify one's inner world. Once this pill was used, it would be no more. From this, one could see just how much money was required to raise an extreme genius. The wealth required to walk down a martial path surpasses my original expectations. No wonder it's impossible for a top genius to appear amongst the wandering martial artists. And it's no wonder that even a great world king level holy land would find it difficult to produce another world king successor after hundreds of thousands or even millions of years. This is why so many world king holy lands like the ancient dragon clan lack successors, Lin Ming thought to himself. He thought about the true martial holy lands. Starbind Bank had already been operating for millions of years, and there were also the many trade associations within immemorial imperial city that fell underneath the control of the true martial holy lands. Just how much wealth had these businesses earned during this time? Perhaps not even the true martial world king was sure, but it was impossible for this wealth to be saved. It had to be spent at ridiculous speeds to help raise the future generations. However, up until now, the true martial holy lands had yet to produce a second world king. They had only produced over 100 successors to the true martial world king. In this divine realm first martial meeting, the true martial world king had even promised a position of successor for any disciple that obtained certain achievements. And to grow each of these successors cost a massive amount of wealth. Even so, the chances of them becoming a world king in the future weren't high at all. Of course, the true martial world king was still in the prime of his life. It was no problem for him to live for another million years or so. He still had hopes that he would be able to produce a world king before his eventual death. If he could guarantee raising a world king, then let alone several trillion, the true martial world king wouldn't hesitate to spend even dozens or hundreds of trillions. It seems that the reason the ancient Phoenix clan, Kirin clan, and Rock clan haven't raised a world king in all these years is that they are too poor. Lin Ming recalled the ancient Phoenix clan's Shandeji and Yuo Burning Heaven. They were both extreme characters of their generation. The totem stones they left behind had filled Lin Ming with inspiration and wisdom. But even then, such characters had been stopped at the half-step world king realm. They hadn't managed to take the last step forwards. At that time, Lin Ming had thought this was unbelievable. But now that he thought about it some more, the reason they couldn't take that last step was not because their talent was too poor and not because the foundation they built during Ninefall and the Nine Divine Shifts was too shaky, but because the ancient Phoenix clan simply wasn't able to afford it. The basis of the ancient Phoenix clan was that they had obtained a secret to finding out where the ancient Phoenix underwent Nirvana and thus were able to obtain the blood of the ancient Phoenix. However, the ancient Phoenix clan didn't even have enough of this blood to use, let alone trading it away for resources. As for the ancient Phoenix clan's resource sites, the most valuable one was the God Beast Mystic Realm. But, while the God Beast Mystic Realm was excellent for tempering geniuses and allowing them to find great lucky chances, its ability to produce wealth was still below that of Carefree Island's Red Desolate Mystic Realm. Of the four God Beast clans, only the ancient Dragon clan had been able to rely on its superior numbers and vastly greater wealth to raise two world kings in a span of 100 million years. Lin Ming could only sigh with emotion as he understood all of this. For a genius, if they couldn't grow because of their lack of talent, then that was their own problem. They had no right to complain. But if they were extremely talented individuals like Adeji or Huo Burning Heaven, and yet failed to break past their boundaries because of insufficient resources, then that was truly sad. In the entire divine realm, there were many people that possessed the talent to become a world king, but lacked the resources to do so. As Lin Ming thought of this, he unconsciously clenched the arm of his seat. No matter what, he would not allow himself to become one of them. This boundless world pill had to be his at all costs. 3.9 trillion, is there a higher bid? Princess Honey Liu excitedly said from atop the auction stage. Her clear voice easily spread throughout the entire arena. Zhong Wenxu adjusted his position in the higher seats. He was the one to call out a bid of 3.9 trillion just now. At this time, with such a huge amount of wealth on the line, even someone as arrogant and proud as him found it hard to remain calm. Suddenly, Lin Ming stood up. He shouted out, 5 trillion, what? Zhong Wenshu glared at Lin Ming, fires nearly spouting out from his eyes. The three prodigies of Sacred Martial Mansion, Sacred Yuping, Sacred Tanhao, and Sacred Yenren, all looked towards Lin Ming. At this time, most of the World King Holy Land disciples that were here had withdrawn from bidding. The only ones left competing were Lin Ming, the Red Bamboo Hat Woman, the three elites of Sacred Martial Mansion, as well as Zhong Wenshu. These were four different parties. To raise the price to 5 trillion in a single breath, that brat must be ridiculously rich. Does he really have the ability to obtain the boundless world pill? Or perhaps he's throwing out his total worth in hopes of scaring everyone away? Zhong Wenshu grasped his chair's armrest, his fist constantly clenching and unclenching. His palms were already wet with sweat. 5 trillion began to approach his total wealth. Within Dual Polarity Palace, Zhong Wenshu wasn't the only peak disciple. There were a total of four, and each of them had a talent similar to the rest, and all four of them needed resources. In a situation where Dual Polarity Palace couldn't guarantee that one of these disciples could become a world king, they wouldn't be willing to spend everything they had regardless of how steep the price was. It simply wouldn't be worth it. This was why they had to carefully consider just how much they should invest in their young geniuses. Thus, although Dual Polarity Palace had mobilized a massive amount of wealth by going through various channels and even selling some of the palace master's own treasures, Zhong Wenshu himself had only been able to obtain 5 trillion. Then, after selling everything he possessed and taking as many loans as he could, he was still only at 5.5 trillion. In fact, in normal circumstances, Dual Polarity Palace wouldn't be willing to support their disciples in purchasing such expensive treasures. If every genius required the best resources on every step of their road of martial arts, Dual Polarity Palace simply wouldn't be able to keep up. 5.5 trillion. Zhong Wenshu grit his teeth and called out his bid. He had tossed out his complete wealth. At this time, he was no longer able to raise the price a little at a time. If he raised the price by 100-200 billion at a time, then his opponent might immediately surpass 5.5 trillion instead. If that happened, then there would be no way for him to raise the price yet again. He could only bet everything on this last desperate gamble and hope that it would work. After he called out this bidding price, he glared at Lin Ming, his eyes filling with a deep cold killing intent. Brat, I advise you not to go too far. If I'm not wrong, then you do not have a fierce backer supporting you. Do you know what fate you will suffer after obtaining the boundless world pill? Many people will chase you to the ends of the world to kill you and take it. You will die without a burial. If you have a life to buy it, then you won't have a life to use it. Even if you did, you would die later regardless of what happened. Lin Ming had intended to stand up and place another bid when he suddenly heard Zhong Wenshu's threat. He sneered. How interesting. I've already attracted enough attention today, so what's the point in grabbing a bit more? This auction site has hundreds of thousands of people present. With such a great number of people, there are innumerable individuals that already have dark intentions towards me. If that's true, I might as well go all in and use this boundless world pill to strengthen myself as much as possible and obtain a good result in the first martial meeting. At that time, just who would still think of killing me? Ha 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 ha. What did you say? Unless I'm wrong, you only have a 9-stage life destruction cultivation and yet you still want to carve a little space for yourself in the first martial meeting. Who do you think you are? A young MP Rin or something? Keep on daydreaming. I'm about to die from laughter. Zhong Wenshu recklessly laughed. If you stop now, then I can protect you. But if you wish to continue fighting with me, then I will have you suffer a fate worse than death. As Lin Ming heard Zhong Wenshu's words, he looked towards him with an unbelievable expression, as if he were watching a clown making a fool of himself. This is the first time in my life hearing such imbecilic and dim-witted words. Seek your protection? Are you expecting me to deliver a piece of me to you or something? As Lin Ming sent out this true essence sound transmission, he decisively stood up again. He locked his eyes onto Zhong Wenshu's murderous gaze and raised his jade slip, clearly shouting, 6 trillion. These words left the entire audience in an uproar. 6 trillion. That was simply insane. Such a crazy bidding scene left everyone thrilled and aghast. Just what background did this youth have? Lin Ming's words smashed into Zhong Wenshu like a wrecking ball. He felt his chest ache as he nearly vomited blood in anger. He no longer had a chance. Good. Very good. Since that's the case, then you can't wait to be surrounded and killed by others. Zhong Wenshu threatened Lin Ming, but the truth was that this wasn't a threat. Everything he said was a fact. At this time, many great influences were ready to thoroughly investigate Lin Ming's status. If Lin Ming didn't have a background, then he would undoubtedly become the target of everyone here. For him to speak such a price was simply far too flashy. Moreover, Lin Ming wasn't like the Red Bamboo Hat Woman. He didn't have the protection of a quasi-world king master. 6 trillion. Is there anyone willing to bid higher? Princess Honey Liuge said, her words coming out in panting gasps. Such a sum of money would even cripple a world king level Holy Land for some time. It was incredible to imagine that this amount would actually come from the hands of an unknown youth.